This is the PilotFish EI console. It's the developer's workstation you use to build, test, maintain, and deploy all of your integration interfaces. We're looking at the supply chain EDI route, doing some purchase order ingestion. So the PilotFish integration model uses a common model to mapping. So how this is put together is we have our source systems on the left, so each row represents a place we're getting data from. Our target systems are on the right, so each row represents a place that we're sending data to. And then no matter how many source and target systems they have, the data goes through the same assembly line process where it's ingested by the listener, transformed, routed to any number of target systems, and then finally sent on to its final destination. So for this route here, since we're doing some purchase order ingestion, we're taking in some EDI via an FTP here. Then we're using our processor stage here to do some asymmetric PGP decryption with some conditional execution. And so next we move into the source transform stage. So at the transform stage here, what we're doing is we're taking our raw EDI and we're turning it into this XML format that we're going to use in the rest of our mappings. So PilotFish uses a common model to mapping, and we use XML as our canonical for all of our underlying data transformation. So we do this in a two-part process, where first we're using a transformation module to take our raw EDI and convert it into XML. And along the way, we're also adding some human-readable friendly names and some segment indexing. The second half of our source transform is a logical mapping. This is an XML to XML mapping using our data mapper, which we'll look at quickly here. So opening up our data mapper, this is our three-pane graphical drag-and-drop mapping tool. And how this is put together is we have our source format on the left, so this is our incoming expected XML structure. We have our target format on the right. This is the XML structure that we're trying to produce. And then you drag and drop into the center pane here and using the tools palette from the top to build your mapping. So here, since we're just doing some EDI validation, we're not altering our structure any. All we're doing is we're validating our CTT elements here. We're making sure that the count of our PO1s equals that CTT. So we're making sure that our line items all equal our total. And then if they don't match, then we're spitting out this validation element. So we're actually adding on to our XML structure here if we have a mismatch, which we'll then use later in our validation steps. So moving back out, next we move into the routing stage. So the routing stage here, we've got some routing rules set up, and this is the primary way of sending a certain message to any subset of target systems. So for example here, I have this rule that I've assembled to say if my BEG07 equals AC, so if my receiver requests an acknowledgement, then I'll go ahead and send a message to my 855 creation route. And in all cases, I want to go ahead and update my database here. So next, moving into our target systems. So since we're updating a database, so we're using a SQL XML. So we're doing another transform here to produce some SQL statements, which our database transport will then run. And then also down here in our second target transform, this is where we're actually producing an EDI 855. So here again, we're using the data mapper to take our 850 and take that information that's required and then producing this 855, again using our data mapper, then using our EDI transformation module to produce that final EDI. So let's see it in action. We'll switch over here to testing mode. I'll feed in this sample 850 file that I have, hit execute test, and we'll see the data move through the system, and we get green checks for all successes and red X's for any failures. So here we can look at our EDI transformation module here. So here we see that EDI transformed into that XML structure. And next we see going through our validation route, we see that we haven't changed that structure at all. And since it looks like our line item total matches up with our baseline data, we haven't added any validation there. So next, moving into our target side, we'll look down here. We're taking that 850, and here we're producing our 855. So here we see that 855 XML. And then finally, using our EDI transformation module to produce that final EDI 855 message to send back to our caller. And then finally, down here on our transport side, we see here that our database insert was successful, but it looks like we had a failure down here on our RESTful endpoint, probably because our sender wasn't ready to receive our response. And it's just that easy. Using the PilotFish EI console, in just a few short steps, we were able to put together this purchase order ingestion workflow, taking in some EDI, doing some validation, and then updating a database, and sending back an 855 response to our caller. I hope you've enjoyed this video. Thank you.